Hello, YouTube. What are we looking at here? Is this a large telemetry tracking tape recorder? Or perhaps it is a large computer data tape recorder, 16 channels. Keep watching Clydesight channel to find out the latest discovery made by Clydesight. Well, as you've probably guessed, this is not a telemetry tracking tape recorder. It is a cassette recorder from the 1960s. This tape recorder is the Magnavox 1v9019 portable cassette tape recorder, which I am dating as approximately 1969 to 1971 or 2 because of the color of the record button located here. It's that tan, mustardy color that was very popular at the time period. It is a very, very basic cassette recorder, but a very high quality machine. And it was not made by Magnavox. It was made for Magnavox by a secret company in Japan, whom we will soon discover when we look inside the unit. There's an eject button located here, which pops the tape out and opens the little cassette door. The inside of the machine is standard for a cassette with the two spindles, the capstan, and it has two heads, an electric record playhead and an electric erase head. There are, on the front, two levers for controlling the machine. Stop and play, and rewind, fast forward. They are not locking. There's also a volume control located here, and the pretty Magnavox badge. On the side we see there's inputs for a microphone with remote, and a speaker output. That's it. On the back, there's nothing. And on the other side, there's nothing. This is an aluminum frame that wraps the entire mechanism. On the back, we see the Magnavox badge with model number and a small grill for a very tiny speaker. You open the machine, and then you pull this up, and this is the way the battery goes. The battery compartment originally contained this carrier for 6 AA batteries to give the 9 volts to the system, but I found that one of these little square transistor batteries works just as well and costs a whole lot less. Another item of interest in this machine, if you look at it carefully, is we see the little motor that runs the system, and inside there we can see the drive belt. Let's take a look at the inside of this machine. To get to the inside of the machine, you remove two screws located here. And then you can very gingerly lift off the back, and very carefully you just simply put it to the side, because they have a little speaker glued to the back, which is wired directly to the amplifier board. And so now here we can see the inside of the unit, and here's the capstan and flywheel, here's the friction clutch mechanism for the take-up, and what appears to be a governor-controlled motor, the rather large coil controlling it. The inside of the mechanism is a little hard to get to because you have to remove this amplifier board. The motor drives the flywheel, and the take-up for the tape is controlled, of course, by this clutch mechanism. The rewind and the fast-forward mechanism is controlled by a wheel located under here, which presses against a rim on the other side of the capstan flywheel. That's basically all there is to this unit. It's a very, very simple mechanical system. So we know that this machine was not made by Magnavox. It was sold by Magnavox and probably others like Westinghouse, RCA, or GE, even Sears. And it is a very good quality machine. If you look at the cover for the battery compartment, there's a little slot right there. And what I believe they had was an adapter that plugged into the snap here, and then the wire came through this little hole, and that is how they were able to use an external power supply with this machine. The machine has a manual recording circuit, and if I can angle it up here, you can see there's a little meter here. Now the interesting thing about the meter is that it doesn't really have any markings on it. It just has three little tiny dots up at the top, and when the pointer is straight up and down, it indicates that the batteries are good or that you're making an optimal recording. If the pointer goes over towards this way clockwise, then you're going a little bit into overdrive. You simply press this record button down, swing over to play, and we're ready to go. Testing, 1, 2, 3, 4, testing, 1, 2, 3, 4. This is a test of the Magnavox 1v9019 cassette tape recorder. This is the end of the test. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, end. Now, all we do is put it back into stop, put the microphone switch back on, and then do a rewind.
1v9019, cassette tape recorder. This is the end of the test. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, end.
The sound on this machine is pretty good through its little speaker, but it's kind of thin and tinny. And what I like to do with a lot of these machines is I pump the power through a powered computer speaker. All we have to do is rewind the tape.
Testing, 1, 2, 3, 4, testing, 1, 2, 3, 4. This is a test of the Magnavox 1v9019 cassette tape recorder. This is the end of the test. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, end.
So you can hear it has very, very good recording quality, and it sounds really super coming through this external powered speaker. The machine also has a safety characteristic, so you can't harm it by pushing the levers incorrectly. So I'm going to put it into play, and I'm going to try to rewind. And you notice nothing happens, and nothing happens in the fast forward either. They've disengaged that part of the mechanism so that you can't mess up the tape or the drive system. So you have to put it into stop, then you can rewind, or you can fast forward, both of which are strong and relatively fast. So there you have it, the Magnavox 1v9019 portable cassette tape recorder. Thank you for watching the video. I hope you enjoyed it, and keep watching Clydesight channel. We have several more tape recorders that we got from eBay, and you will find them very interesting and unusual. Bye-bye, YouTube.